for 25 years. All natural, no caffeine. Gin Sauna, for active people.
Jonelle presents salon-style sculptured nails. Easy to apply, just stick it, buff it, gel it, set it. You'll love it. Gel nails from Jonelle.
Guest accommodations provided by the Hotel Maclo. Experience style and sophistication for business or leisure. The New York Times says the interiors are among the city's most impressive. For reservations, call 1-800-MACK-LOW.
Thousands watched the skies over West Michigan as the moon got in the way of the sun. Tonight on News 3 at 6, we'll shed some light on the event of a lifetime.
One government agency says it's okay, but another says, wait a minute, when it comes to storing nuclear waste along the lakeshore.
An assisted suicide law is struck down and murder charges reinstated against Jack Kevorkian. The reasons why, next on News 3 at 6.
And you're watching WWMT, West Michigan's Channel 3. This is News 3 at 6.
Hello, West Michigan. The sun came up this morning, but something funny happened to it along the way, all along America's heartland.
Did you see it? There was a magnificent eclipse of the sun this afternoon. The experts say this was our only chance many people had to see such a sight in their lifetime. The skies were crystal clear, as blue as far as you could see. Most observers began noticing the moon first, making serious progress in crossing the sun right around the noon hour. These pictures were taken at McCamley Park in downtown Battle Creek. As the moon floated in its orbit, it came directly through the sun's path, cutting more and more of the sun's rays. You can see that as of the 1 o'clock hour, as it approached, the moon began nearly blocking the energy from our big star. The grand moment for folks equipped to see the heavenly event came a little past 1 p.m. when a ring of sunlight called the annulus was all the way around the moon, a sensational sight. Today's stunning solar cover-up was predicted by astronomers well in advance, in plenty of time for people to plan to be in the right, perfect place to see it. Among those who hit the road to find the center of the eclipse path were News 3's Peter Chan and photojournalist Dean Cummings. They ventured south to a camp near Warsaw, Indiana.
For a couple of dozen people from West Michigan, the perfect place to view the eclipse was to come at the end of a bus ride.
We're going to an observatory that's owned by the Astronomy Association from Warsaw, and it's at a YMCA camp.
Members of the Grand Rapids Amateur Astronomical Association teamed up with their Hoosier colleagues at a small observatory near Warsaw, Indiana.
Yeah, we're the luckiest people on the planet. This is the luckiest astronomy club there is today. I'm sure they do pretty good up in Fort Wayne, but these are ideal conditions.
We'll get this set up.
No time was wasted in setting up a small fortune in telescopes, cameras, and other gear to view and record the solar spectacle.
Nothing, it's just a round green spot.
Viewing began in earnest when the moon made its first contact with the sun. Behind the safety of solar filters, the mood of the group grew in anticipation as the time of mid-eclipse grew near. Outside, it grew dim like you were looking through sunglasses. The temperature fell 9 degrees from the beginning to mid-eclipse, and the planet Venus even made a brief appearance.
We came, we saw, we conquered. It was a spectacular annular solar eclipse visible here from north central Indiana. We had ideal weather conditions. The viewing was terrific.
The next huge solar event for West Michigan in the science of orbital mechanics will be on April 8th, 2024. That's when there will be a total eclipse of the sun near enough to us to be worth driving to the center of the path of the eclipse.
I didn't see anything particularly unusual, no raccoons wandering about aimlessly, but I did have to hold up a table to act as a windbreaker as my friend was taking photographs of this eclipse through his telescope, and I hope to have photographs of the eclipse on Saturday's newscast at 6.
In time for your next weathercast, and I like the hat, Peter.
Oh, thanks a lot.
Thanks.
Eclipsing his head. Much of West Michigan stopped in his tracks to track the awesome sight. Everybody was into it at the downtown Kalamazoo Mall for Eclipse Fest 94. The baker's recipe for viewing? Well, they're supposed to be good with their hands. The welders on the Arcadia Creek project,
They're good at using the tools of their trade. Their helmets are always used to shield their eyes from dangerous light. The planetarium brought its telescopes. Ryder's Hobby Shop provided special eclipse viewing shades made of mylar to protect eyes from radiation. Even the shade from the downtown trees served as natural lenses, a second phenomenon this day. On Drake Road, these high school students, among the 500 from Kalamazoo and Van Buren counties, in a massive project to track the northern edge of the eclipse. They brought with them their own devices.
A lot of people spend thousands of dollars to fly to places like this. Is our backyard. We walk out, we line up, and we see this live. Plus, they know they're taking part in, you know, science. It's not just a cookbook experiment.
Our students' observations will help scientists worldwide in determining the actual position of this astronomical event.
And those kids will be exactly my age today when the next big solar eclipse occurs here 30 years from now. Many school children missed it today because teachers took no chances with them peeking at it with the naked eye. They stayed indoors. Now, what were you doing during the solar eclipse? Did you notice strange things where you were? Well, you can call us between now and 8 p.m. with your best solar eclipse anecdotes. In the Kalamazoo area, the number is 388-9339, or toll-free from other areas, 1-800-875-3333. We'll mention the best eclipse tales as part of our stellar solar coverage. Are we having fun now or what? On segment 3 tonight, on News 3's 7 at 11.